here, please. Let's go before God. Let him know that you are in his presence. Just tell him you are in his presence. Let him know that you are here. Let him know our Father. Let him know our Father. We are in your presence, oh God. Let him know the way, oh God. We are here in the home of our Father.
We lift our marriages unto you, O God, and we pray our Father and our God.
because of you, our Father, we are here with them. Our Father, let your name and your word be inscribed in their hearts, O God, as they grow, our Father and our God. May they grow in wisdom. May they grow in knowledge. May they grow in your fear, O God. May they call you their God. May the children of our children call you their God. In the mighty name of Jesus. And our Father, we pray that this morning, O God, that every mountain that has honored in our lives, every mountain that has lifted in our lives, O God, even as your word says, our Father, that you shall bring the mountains low, we decree and declare that there is no mountain that shall stand in our way. There is no mountain that shall stand in the way of our lives, in the way of the gospel. Every mountain shall come low, every low shall come high. O God, knowing that this is the year of general election, our Father and our God, we pray this nation unto your hands. We know that you are a God of this nation. Kenya belongs unto you, our Father. Kenya belongs unto you, Almighty. Let your name be lifted in this nation. Let your name be lifted in our politics. Let your name be lifted in our leaders, in our opposition leaders, in our president, in our MPs, O God. Let them walk with your fear. In Father, and we shut down every mouth that has helped to bring tribalism. We shut down every mouth that has brought to bring, oh God, hunger. In this nation, there shall be no fight among us in tribe. There shall be no racism. In this year 2017, and every evil leader that is supposed to be raised by the evil horse, your time is over. We command and declare that you shall not see the light of the day. We are shutting them down. We are destroying them in the mighty name of Jesus. We pray for peace in this nation. We pray for peace in our lives. We pray for peace in our hearts. We pray for peace in our marriages. May you hold God, our Father. Attend to our situation. Gather in your presence, O God. Let the hopeless have hope, O God. Let the weak be strong, our Father. Let the sick be healed, O God. In the mighty name of Jesus. We pray this service unto your able hands. We commit the service unto you. Holy Spirit of the living God, may you reign in this service. Let your word, let your influence be seen in our service. Let your power be seen in our service. May your wonders, let your miracles, and let your signs follow us this service. In the mighty name of Jesus. And every plan of the enemy, every wickedness of the enemy that is meant in this altar, commanding you out in the name of Jesus Christ. Every evil agenda, every agent of the enemy that is in our midst right now, we command you out in the name of God. Yes, in the name of Jesus. And let you reign for this we pray. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. And everyone say amen. Amen and amen. Yes, let's have our seat. My name is Apius. Same. I love Jesus and I know he loves me. So I'm here also to give us the announcement or the updates for today, being the 5th of March 2017. The first update is daily evening prayers going on in the during the course of the week. These are prayers that start from Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday. They start at 6 to 7:30. Praise God. Please purpose to attend those prayers. We are highly lifting this nation before God, even in this year of general election. We are praying for peace in our nation. We not only come to pray for ourselves, but we are majoring so much in the nation. Praise God. Please, if you get a moment, come here that time, 5:30 to 7:30, and we shall be blessed together. Second update, bless to bless meeting on Sunday the 12th. That is next Sunday, bless to bless meeting. And Junction Fellowship is in charge of kitchen to prepare the lunch that day, and priest papas to attend. All ladies, bless to bless. Praise God.
Amen.
Our third update is our pay bill number shall be casted on the screens right now. It is 834894. That is a pay bill. See all the M-Pesa, the pay bill, praise God. So that account is used and will be used for committing the tithes, the offering, and any other project that shall be raised in this in the church. Please use that pay bill to send your tithe, to send your offering, to send any other commitment or pledges you have pledged. Mahali kunawekwa jina, you put the name, what you are paying for. That is, if you are paying for tithe, you put tithe and just one name. Praise God.
Amen.
If you are paying for, you are committing your offering, put offering and one name, your name. Praise God. If you are committing for a pledge, just write the pledge, the name of the pledge you are paying for, and then one name, and we shall be blessed. Praise God.
Amen.
Adonai 46. This is ladies on duty. Group leader is Mrs. Purity or Peter. Praise God. So that is an announcement. Adonai 46. Those are the ladies on duty. Whatever your spirit. Wherever you are, let's hear higher. Yeah, so those are the announcements for today. Update. Please let's stand together as we welcome our pastor, Pastor James Gilmore. Let's stand.
Amen. Praise God. Hi. Bwana sifiwe. How are you today? How was your week? Time to somebody give them high five. Tell them it's good to see you. Tell them it's a blessing to be with you. Tell them I'm happy you are my neighbor today. Ask them how was your week. Tell them it's a pleasure to be in the house of God. Hallelujah. Amen. How many know God is in our midst and God is in charge of our life? And there is no devil. There is nothing that the devil can do against us. Because we have put our trust in the living God. Amen.
Amen.
Lift up your hands. Give him a clap offering this morning in Jesus' name. Praise the name of the Lord.
Waajabu. Wewe waajabu. Oh,
values in Jesus' name. And someone say amen.
Amen.
Now, there was one brother of Jesus among the disciples of Jesus. I don't know whether you know. Katikati ya wale mitume kumi na wawili, palikuwa na moja alikuwa ni ndugu yake Yesu. Are you aware? Jina lake aliitwa nani? Yuda.
Jude.
Jude was the brother of Jesus. And he was among the writers ambao waliandika the New Testament. Lakini huyu mtu wa Mungu ndugu yake Yesu alifaulu kuandika ukurasa moja peke yake wa Biblia. Only one chapter. And in that one chapter, verse number 20 of the book of Jude, Jude is next to the Give us with the because just, if you are opening the Bible, it is next to Revelation. You can look for that one. I know you, it's not one of the most commonly read books. And you read one chapter, but in that one chapter, in verse 20, and asema hivi. 1, 2, 3, read with me, everyone. But you, dear friends, build yourselves up in your most holy faith and pray in the Holy Spirit. Verse 121 and 22. Keep yourselves in God's love as you wait for the mercy of our Lord Jesus Christ to bring you to eternal life. Verse number 22. Be merciful to those who now continue, please. Continue. Snatch others from the fire and save them. To others, show mercy. To him who is able to keep you from falling and to present you before his glorious presence without fault and with joy. To the only God our Savior be glory, majesty, power, and authority through But you, dear friends, build yourself up in the most holy faith, praying in the Holy Ghost. Amen.
Amen.
Praying in the Holy Ghost. But you, turn to your neighbor now. Tell them, but you, dear friends, build yourself up.
Build yourself up.
In your most holy faith.
In your most holy faith.
By praying, in the Holy Ghost.
In the Holy Ghost.
Now turn to the person next to you and tell them, but you, my dear friend, build yourself up.
Build yourself up.
In your most holy faith.
In your most holy faith.
How many are with me? Wanna see you?
Yeah.
In fact, we have before he talks of this, he talks about the pervasiveness that is there in the world. Na corruption, na nini, na evil, na maovu yale yanayoendelea ambayo yanaweza fanya mtu wa Mungu asushwe moyo, akue chini, aone hakuna tumaini, akufe moyo, akose sababu ya kuishi. There are so many things in this world and in this life that are fighting you. But you, amen. Bwana asifiwe. That is why we gather in the house of God. We gather here so that we may be able to build ourselves up. That we may build ourselves up.
Amen.
May somebody be built up in this service.
Amen.
Watch out to a jengeke. Watch out to a jengeke. portfolio. Kwake yeye awezae na ana uwezo wa kukushikilia.
kwanza hakuamini ya kwamba huyu Yesu ndiye Mesia. Na even wait, and then mukae. Thank you. God bless you.
Thank you.
Give them a clap of praise as they go to see. Thank you. Thank you. And you are smart.
Thank you.
Yeah. You look dark, not very bright, not very dull, but smart. Yeah. And you have a good spirit. May God bless you now. Amen. Ukiona ndugu ya mtu ambaye hakuamini huyu ndugu yake ni yeye mwana wa Mungu. Na katika mahali fulani walimnenea wakamwambia, vile maneno umeanza wewe kijana mdogo wetu, tu hatukuelewi. Fanya hivi, nabii hasikikawi kwa
wao.
Fanya hivi, tutoke hapa kwetu, utebetebe, ujipe shughuli, utebetebe. By the time unafika Naivasha na hapo hivyo Nakuru, kuelekea Malimajo, yawezekana watu wenye hawakujui watakusikiliza. Lakini hapa ni ngumu sana kutusababisha tukuelewe. We don't understand you. And it is recorded in the book of Mark, and then chapter 5, that Jesus never did any great miracles in his own hometown because of the reception he had from his own brothers. But the interesting story is that our watu waliona wakasikia kile kinachotendeka kupitia ndugu huyu yao mdogo. Until one of them, he became a follower of Jesus. Na baadaye yeye ndiye anaandika haya maneno, anasema scripture, and Jesus never did great miracles in his own story. I don't know whether it is Mark chapter 5. I don't know now. If you are searching, you better search. Unfortunately, I don't know. Now, huyu ndugu yao anakuja na anasema kwake yeye ambaye ana uwezo wa kutuhifadhi tusianguke. Amen. Bwana asifiwe. Is that a powerful testimony? From a person, ndugu yao ambaye walihamuamini. But now he says, to him who is able to keep you from falling, to the only wise God, our Father, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Through Jesus Christ our Lord. He is not saying, through Jesus Christ my brother. Uh-huh. In fact, Jesus was the brother, but Christ was the anointed one. So when he uses the two names, Jesus Christ, he is not referring to his brother that time. He is referring to the anointed one, the Messiah, Emmanuel, God together with us. May he keep you. May he keep you from falling. May he keep your family. I say, may he keep you. What a kuhifadhi. Alifadhi maisha yako. Alifadhi watoto wako. Alifadhi jamii yako. Katikati ya hizi hali ambazo tunapitia ngumu, wacha akuhifadhi. Acha akuhifadhi.
Amen.
Somebody say, I am preserved.
I am preserved.
Therefore no evil can befall me. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Somebody say, my father is preserved.
My father is preserved.
Somebody say, I am hidden.
I am hidden.
In Jesus Christ.
In Jesus Christ.
Therefore I am safe.
Therefore
I am secure.
I am safe.
In Jesus' name.
Yes.
Amen and amen.
Amen.
If you believe it, give him another clap offering this morning. I love to give him clap offerings in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Now, I have three things to do very fast before we get into the contents of the word. Number one, I appreciate all of you.
Amen.
You are a great people. Good to see you. Tell to somebody, tell them we are a great family. Tell them God is with us. Tell them we are going very far. Tell them God's presence is upon us to do us good. In Jesus' name. I appreciate all of you. I love this church. I love this church. One said, yesterday I was in Nyahururu. I normally go every Saturday of the month. I have to be in Nyahururu meeting with our pastors in the area of Nyahururu, which we still lead as much as we are here. And one of them, in fact, later when I came back, somebody called. He said, Pastor, we don't understand why you have to come to Nyahururu every time and go back to Nairobi. You are supposed to at least to come and be with us here. I told them, I would wish, but my heart I have some things that are urgent in my spirit to handle. One at Kuzwe San. And we talked for almost 1 hour, somebody complaining how they have been there, but especially in Kinamba. And I say, now that tells you I am committed. I am committed to this church. I am committed. Bwana asifiwe. Ulitoka nikiwa pale chini nikiongea na simu. Ukaenda sijui ulienda wapi na ukarudi. Bado nikiwa kule chini. Tulikuwa tuna ilikuwa kesi kuu. Na kesi haikuwa maneno mengine. Ilikuwa mali imetoka kinani. Kwa hivyo Mungu anisaidie. Mungu anisaidie. Unajua wewe unaweza kuwa unasikia Pastor Gikwa hapa unachukua for granted ile nafasi tu ya kuwa pamoja tukishiriki neno la Mungu. Pasipo kujua kuna mtu mwingine mahali kwingine anatamani angepata hiyo nafasi. Tell somebody, never take for granted the opportunity that God has given you. Pia Yesu makofi kama unaelewa tunaongea kuhusu mimi. Bless be the name of God. I am so proud of you. This week I got a report. Huyu ndugu, I am proud of Sam. Siniyamadhali kusema. You know, I believe in giving credit where honor is. Sam anauzaga magari kama hujui na unakuuza, kununua na kuuza, na kuuza na kununua. Hiyo ndio biashara yake. And one bishop, a friend of mine, who prayed for me to get saved. We were with him in Moja Secondary School. He called me and told me he wants to sell his car. And I told him I have a brother who can do that without any problem. And I gave him the number of Sam. Nikamwambia get in touch with him. So immediately they got in touch. Yeye aliachilia gari yake. The bishop akapatia kijana yake gari, aletee Sam. Kwa hivyo Sam akapatiwa gari na funguo na logbook. Akaaminiwa aende auze ile gari. So jana the bishop called me and told me Sam managed to sell the car. Now the interesting thing is this. Huyo bishop hawajawahi onana macho na huyu ndugu. Alimtuma account. Alituma account ya benki na akapeana gari na funguo na robo. Wewe niambie hii Kenya na Nairobi. Mtu hamjawahi onana. Lakini mimi kama pastor nimemwambia I have a pastor who can do that. Ya kwamba anapeana gari yake, anapeana funguo, anapeana logo na anatuma account. Wewe ukiuza, weka hiyo pesa kwa hiyo account na hawajali onana mpaka saa hii. So someone said yesterday to sell that car, akaniambia pesa nimewekea bishop account yake, gari imeenda na transactions zote tumefanya. Nikasema thank God. Those are the people we need today. And those are the people we need. The money is in the account of the bishop. Sasa, may God bless you. Amen. And may God reward you for your faithfulness. Unapoenda kufanya biashara kwa njia kama hizo, the sky is not the limit. God is going to promote you and God is going to take you far. Receive our thanksgiving in Jesus' name. Asante, unaweza keti.
Amen.
Amen.
Isn't that good testimony?
Yes.
Isn't that great?
Yes.
Is that just something to thank God for?
Yes.
Ni watu wangapi utakuta hii Nairobi? Hii Nairobi. Atutamwaminia kiwango hicho. Ni wangapi? Nafikiri ni wachache. Ni wachache kwa sababu ninajua kile ninasema. Kuna watu wako diaspora ambao waliacha ndugu zao na dada zao huku. Wanatumana pesa wanunuliwe plot. Sasa anarudishwa barabara plot tumenunua. Na anapigiwa picha, anatumiwa, anaambiwa proti ndio hii. Tulinunua pale dhika mahali mzuri sana. Na sasa tumeanza mjengo, tuma pesa ya mjengo. Jamaa anaendelea kutuma pesa kwa ndugu yake. 5 years later, jamaa anagundua hakuna proti na hakuna kitu